is cheating.
Conniving.
This is why you can't
conniving
believe
and
men.
Manipulating.
Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new, hi, I'm Nandria.
And I'm Greg Ann.
And I'm Donnie.
So as you guys can tell by the title of this video, we will have a girl talk. Yeah, I hope you guys like. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.
Okay, so we're gonna start with
being young in a relationship. Mm-hmm, okay. And this is like 16 and up. 16 yeah. to 20.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I have a lot of experience. To start off, I would like to say don't let any man take pieces of you.
Period. That's dead facts, because guys will really come into your life.
Wait, this opens?
Really, nigga?
Guys will really get into a relationship and be worth nothing, and then like suck the life out of you.
Damn.
And then leave you there high and dry. And you're just like, I molded you. I made you. Remember when what's her name? Ciara told Future that? Like they in her song.
Baby. You acting like you upgraded me, I upgraded you. You and me fashion week in Paris, I put you on to that new.
I just feel like a lot of them don't know what they want. Like, I don't know. Not in my case. Cause in my case that said person knew. But
Did.
Cause he's awesome. Canceled, bro. But that person knew what they wanted. But it was just like like you cannot let these men, I almost said the word, you cannot let these men take peace of you. If you feel like you're not yourself, bro, this is cliche, mm-hmm. but this is dead facts though. Mm-hmm. Like this is no joke, nothing. If you don't feel like yourself or you could be yourself around them and your friends is telling you you're not yourself around them, dash that man.
Dash him
away. He's gone, bro. Like, I think you should also value your friends' opinions.
That's
but
true.
Not too much where you're like listening to what they're saying or they're controlling your relationship. Like, it has to be a nice little balance.
Because I feel a lot of time as women, we always want to compromise to make the relationship work. But when you're compromising too much, then you just gotta cancel that. And then our friends be seeing what we can't see because we blinded by our feelings. For these waste men out here. But like, that's what she was saying. Like, listen to your friends, but not listen too much.
And then also, it's like the timing, like time does not matter. Like, I feel like I need to stress this. You could be with that person for a mad long and he could still be trash.
Yeah, trash. But as a young person, I feel like you really shouldn't be taking these relationships dead serious.
It depends.
I don't know, bro, it depends.
Because sometimes there are relationships that succeed
one in
and
100.
They be mad happy. Like, for example, Kadeem and Deval. You know those? Bro,
they
you
had,
know
they
them,
had
bro.
A rough patch.
Yeah, okay.
Well, everyone has a rough patch.
Everybody has.
But I'm just saying.
They've been together since high school. So it's okay.
Maybe. That's one in how many? One in how many, y'all? Like, especially when you're literally graduating from high school to college. How many of those last?
This one right here hopped out her relationship once she got
hopped
out. I wasn't trying to put you on the joke.
Okay,
right,
first of all,
she hopped out, bro.
It was a month into college. So yep. Was that hopping or was that a little bit of
Shawty
time?
Said she stepped out.
I stepped out for them. I could have went back. I mean, I guess I did, but then again, I didn't.
Okay, but yours lasted. Why yours lasted and hers didn't?
Mine didn't last because I was really taking for a poppy show. Like, what?
Wow, don't let them take it for a poppy show either. You always want to say when a guy or a girl cheats on them, they out, right? Mm. But you never know what's going to happen when you're in the situation.
Praise the Lord on that. I feel like responding to cheating is to each his own. I personally believe that if I was ever put into that situation, would leave.
I will be petty.
You cheat back?
I ain't say all of that.
Would you cheat back, yes or no?
Knowing me, probably, but also I feel like I will be just have to play it off like I don't know. And then slowly but surely slip out.
Girl,
if that makes sense.
Just be dramatic and leave.
No, like, I'm gonna make him feel that I'm leaving. I'm gonna make him wanna beg me to stay.
But most times when the guy cheats, most times, it's with somebody they don't care about anyway. So.
So, but, yeah, but see, that don't make sense.
When you leave,
that don't make sense.
They'll still be hurting regardless if they didn't care.
You have to gauge the person and you have to figure out, okay, do you really believe that, okay, they can change from the situation, or do you believe that, okay, they're gonna remain the same person from the cheating?
But I feel like you can't really judge that because he or she will lie.
Yeah.
Triggered.
Like, once a cheater, always a cheater, period. That's just what it is.
Because if you cheated once and you love...
No, I'm a believer that the first time was a mistake, the second time was a choice.
There is no mistake.
But the fact that you can make that mistake and you claim that you
care about
me or care about me,
mm-hmm.
like, that's when I take you for a joke.
Bro, how can it be a mistake? How do you mistakenly take off your pants and stick your pee-pee in?
Right! Like, that comes with intention, bro. But, intention.
But, okay, do you guys feel like emotional cheating is cheating? Or is it just physical cheating?
Yes.
Like, emotional as in you like somebody
else? Honestly,
like, talking to somebody else and you're in a relationship.
Honestly, I feel like that's how
if
I would cheat
case,
if I would have
done cheated.
Exactly. So, it's kind of easy to cheat.
You know, there's emotional and physical cheating.
Yes, and some guys think emotional cheating is not a big deal, but I think every type of cheating is a big deal.
Period. That's what my
sister
said. No, but, okay.
For me,
if you like somebody else, right?
Mm-hmm. Ooh, child.
If you like somebody else and you're in a relationship, me personally, I believe if you want to act on liking that person, then you just have to leave.
Yeah.
Like, you,
definitely.
Like, that is, it's impossible for you, because at that point, you're building a connection with two people. You have a connection with somebody
already.
And
soul ties are real, y'all.
And, as they say, don't let your boyfriend let you miss out on your husband. Like,
wow, that is what cheaters say. Don't listen to that. We're not all Alicia Keys. We're not
see?
All.
She got it, though. She
but
got
my point
it,
is we're not all them. Okay? That's 1 in 100,000 or whatever it is.
I just feel like...
Oh, I feel... Actually, now that I'm thinking about it, I might be the type to be like a frying pan woman.
Ah!
I'm gonna sit silent,
to go to
but
jail.
The longer I sit silent, the more my blood will boil.
And sometimes niggas don't be having the same values as you, to be honest.
Ooh.
Like, I value honesty and respect and trust. And when I found out that, okay, my boyfriend cheated on me, right? I found out, right?
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't say anything to him for months, to be honest. Like, it was like a...
That was a couple weeks.
No, like...
You're brave.
No. I didn't say anything to him for months because the way I found out that he was cheating was sneaky, and I kept asking him after that, like, I would be like, oh, have you ever kissed anybody while we were together? Or have
that's
you?
What I mean.
That's what I was doing, and I just needed him to be honest. Like,
but honestly, I don't feel like anything happens. Like, you finding out that somebody cheated doesn't happen by accident.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. And then once
like
you
that's
have
your
the...
gut, that's your intuition, and that's mm-hmm. God.
No, but once you have the Carfax, I don't believe in prolonging anything.
Mm-hmm.
Please answer me now.
Now, sometimes you gotta prolong it for your own sanity,
bro. There is no sanity at that point for me.
Screaming.
There is no sanity. The minute I find out is the minute I would like answers, please and thank you.
Mm-hmm. And it was crazy to me because the person was like, oh, I love you. He was the one saying that he wanted a relationship from me and stuff like that. And then you turn around and just
conniving.
This is why you can't
conniving and manipulating. And I sound hurt because I am.
Screaming.
But I don't know how you did that, though.
Like she said, to each his own. Mm-hmm. I feel like I would have multiple reactions. It depends on the person, honestly. If I really like them, I might approach them off rip or kill them.
That's what I'm saying.
If I'm not really into it, I'm going to be like, all right, I'm going to let you rock.
But if you're not into it, why are you in a relationship?
Because feelings have to progress.
I am a firm believer in that one.
Like, me finding out you cheated 2 months into the relationship is different from me finding out you cheated 2 years into the relationship.
True. Yes. True. But even, yeah, that's true. Because when I was with high school one, it took me a long time to get to where I was. Mm-hmm. Like, a mad long, like.
Mm-hmm. And the next thing is, I realized that guys can't take cheating. Like, they be dishing it, but they can't.
That's the double standard I'm talking about. They be calling us weak. They be calling us, we overreacting.
But you know what it is?
All you can do is sneeze in a guy's direction. She for the streets.
She belongs to the streets.
Come on, bro. Come on, bro.
But it goes back to my point. Like, it's like, that's what it is. They cheat with people that they don't care about just to get a nut. La, 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 la. And if I'm gonna cheat, I'm gonna find somebody that I can leave you for.
Right. But in my head, it's like, it's not just a nut. Cause one, you find her attractive.
Two, that's not even true.
You find
Cause she could just have a big butt, bro, and they'll be like,
screaming.
But the fact that you put energy into talking to her, to setting up that link.
But some people don't even need, like, some females out here are really easy, bro.
That's
some
true.
Slide type bitch.
Like, some what slide?
You have money, bro. If you're a man and you have money,
you have to have money.
If you have look a like car, you have money. Look like you have money.
And if you know how to dress, the trish dem is on you, bro. You're sanctioned. You are sanctioned, my king. He's a king.
So I got into my first relationship like literally like 3 weeks before we graduated high school, right? And I was just
really that. Yes, bro, because you remember senior trip.
Right,
grand,
right.
The grand review.
Been in a relationship and I was like, I'm gonna try it out and see what it's about, right? And we would talk and he would be like I didn't care if we broke up or not because we was just dating for 2 weeks 3 weeks, but he was like, he wanted to try the long distance shit for me.
No ma'am.
So I was like, okay, and that's why I went into college in a relationship.
But also, it's different because she was home. She was home, and that person was away, and I was away, and that person was away too.
I'm not gonna hold you guys. If I was on a campus, I feel like I would have been a little treesh on the campus.
Not a treesh.
Not a
treesh.
You would not be no damn
treesh.
You would not be.
But
I mean, no, because when she went in the summer to that thing, she was
in a treesh. She was having fun. That's true. She was gonna stay. That's true.
If she had way more time, she would have.
That's true.
I don't want to say broke up, but
no, she would have just been involved, bro.
Yeah.
Like I was involved, but I wasn't no treesh. Nobody in that school could say they touched me.
I don't that's mean true. Like that, but I mean like I would.
Oh, I meant
open.
Like that.
No, I didn't mean like that. I meant like open to meeting new people, like just not being tied down, basically. Like
true.
I would have been exploring, but not. And I feel like as a woman, it's okay to explore. Like, a lot of people want to tie down women and be like, oh, you need to just be about your books. But no, baby girl, you need to live your life for you. Like, oh my God.
Not even the books, bro. It's the bodies for me. It's the bodies for me.
Like, they really be trying to limit us.
Like, 15 million bodies. And as soon as you have 4 bodies, bro,
it's
like,
dead.
She been around the block because there's 4 corns on the block. Like,
I get it.
They think they comedians until they meet me. Cause I'm a real comedian.
She's a clown. That's what she is. She's a clown.
But
that double standard, do not let it like hinder you from doing anything. You don't need to give a rat's booty about what other people think. The only people that should matter is you,
yourself, and God. That's it.
Right. If you feel like God and you is good, it's close, it's set, like it shouldn't matter what nobody said.
My thing is, don't matter if you have 1 body, 2 bodies, 3 bodies. If you believe
as long as
that you're
safe,
going to go to hell,
you have no body. That's
bro,
all that matters.
Each
let's
year,
not be delusional.
Each year, your body count gets deleted.
But for real though, as long as you're safe, I think that's actually very important. You can have as many bodies as you want, but as long as you safe, sis.
And get checked, please, I beg.
And while y'all are being safe out there, y'all also need to be wise in the partners that you choose.
That's a very good point. be careful who you choose as partners for real, because some of these people out here, whether it's male or female, they are very childish. Like, I've seen cases where girls will say that they were raped, etc., or false claim on a young king, because you are kings, despite some of your actions. Anyway, they will false claim because, like, the boy doesn't want to be serious, and they're like, oh, but you said X, Y, Z, and then they'll be like, oh, he, because it's mostly he raped me, he sexually assaulted me, blah, blah, blah. And that's just not the fact.
But that also goes for women too, because men will really drag your name through the dirt. When men can't get what they want, they will disrespect you to no extent. They will tell their bros. They will tell their bros. They will tell their sisters. Their sisters will tell their friends. And then next thing you know, you the campus hoe.
But I'm at fault. If my bros tell me something and I don't like
you, don't believe in it, right?
Like, shit.
We all gotta check ourselves. We dead gotta check ourselves at times.
I am guilty. Like,
why are we believing it at first?
That's true. But if you're hearing it from multiple people,
then it still could be a rumor, though.
It could. It's but just also could not. They could be rumors, but they could also not. So.
And that's why we go back to the same point that the only opinion that should matter is yours. Because you know what you do with your life. You know how it happened.
How they gonna tell you how much bodies you got?
So
they was there?
You definitely gotta build a tough skin when it comes to like college, because or like just like life after high school.
In high school, you should just have a tough skin, period. In other news, a little tidbit I would also like to say, if said partner would like to receive but doesn't want to give, you must run.
It's all about reciprocity. Especially because men don't be doing much for women in the first
place. And
it's
not Christmas. We're not in the spirit of giving.
You're corny.
It is what it is, bro. This is not corny. Christmas.
It is what it is.
Go away.
You didn't even give no context. Okay.
Go away for college. If you do not go away, you're going to regret it.
Oh, let's talk about this.
I went away and I still regret leaving school early. Go away.
I also regret.
Go away for school. I to this day, bro.
They did 2 years of college and I did 3 years, and I still feel like I should have did the full 4 years. Do you feel like that or no?
No.
I'm glad I got out.
She didn't go away.
She didn't go away. The key is to go away, y'all.
Bro. Go away.
I just can't waste 4 full years in college when I don't have to. Like, that's a waste of time, bro.
Bro, I understand that. But if I stayed, I would feel the same way.
I would be mad that I would have to pay. But that's literally the only thing I would be mad about.
I was there. Well, the only reason I didn't stay for real for that extra third year is because my financial aid was going to run up.
Yeah, and that's the same for me. Like, I could not afford a fourth year. But if I could have, if I had a scholarship or something that was covering that fourth year, best believe I would have stayed. I would have taken bullshit classes.
Bro, just I would have got a minor, bro. I would have done a major, bro.
No, for real. Because I don't know what it is, but I just feel like college is a, like, the purpose of college is growth. Like, aside from the classes and stuff, growth.
And meeting so many new people. I made some
facts.
Well, I actually didn't make that many friends. I made some friends there. Okay. And they're lifelong friends.
For real.
Mm-hmm. Like, lifelong. Like, you get your little drama. Don't think just because you left high school, why is he
okay? Staring at us.
Just don't think because you left high school, there's not going to be a drama. Because I had no drama in high school.
Oh, there was drama.
And
if I wasn't so involved in drama, it, there was still drama. No.
People you know.
People
your
you
friend.
Don't know.
Yeah, like, there's sometimes you just get dragged into the drama. Like, sorry. Reverse,
but that's just like one of the downsides.
Yeah, but it's like, what I like is that you're forced to make friends. Like me, I'm not the type like, hey girl, my name is blah blah blah. No, not at all. But in college, it's like you have to, or you're alone and depressed.
And I feel like when you go away, you're forced to grow up. Cause like when I was in college, that was the first time I got a job. That was the first time I registered to vote. All of that stuff.
True.
First time I drank alcohol.
What?
Yeah, bro. I'm trying to remember. I really don't think I drank alcohol before college. Like, the growth is crazy, especially when you go away. But, like...
Especially if you have to have a job. Because I was fortunate enough not to have a job.
Child. And that was stressful.
My parents did send me money. But it's still, like... I didn't really like to ask, but I was never going to deny it. Let's make that very clear.
And I'm not saying, like, go out and get a job. But if you don't need to get a job, don't kill yourself.
Don't get a job if you don't need it.
Because school is already stressful enough. Don't add that extra stress in.
And then... You kind of just want to be involved on campus. Like, I would suggest the first semester at least don't get a job. You got yours, right? Right.
No, I got mine the second semester.
Yeah, like your first semester, I think
you should
take time. Yeah, like.
So I could fail.
And I,
And remember what you went there for. You didn't, you didn't go there to make money.
Right.
You went there to get your education so you can make money in the future. That's it. And also, it's all about balance, honestly. Because I know some days I had an 8:45 almost every single semester that I was there. Yeah. 8:45, 8:15. Like, they used to grease me.
We had 8:05. I had that one semester,
My 8:45, I would be out with my friends till 3 in the morning on a Tuesday, Wednesday. And best believe I had to get up and go to that 8:15. Because I remember my freshman year, I had a 9:20. I missed 3 classes and I ended up getting a C in that section of my course. So I could have got an A in the class, but I ended up getting a B because I
was playing around.
Yeah, the freedom was getting to my neck, bro.
What was it like being home?
That's true, because we
over here talking about all this stuff. I barely remember, honestly. I would just go to school and come home and that's it. And then the last year of college, that's when I got a job and I was doing an internship at the same time. And that's when
the stress started
for real. Like, I was out of my house almost 7 days a week because I would work like Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and then Fridays I would go to school from 8 to like 11 and then go to work from 3 to 11 p.m. and then wake up the next day and do that. Like, I don't know how I was doing that because now I can't even do it. I had no social life. Like, I didn't care about my social life. I was still talking to my friends every single day, so it was like nothing.
Yeah, you're really the OG fan.
Bro, no new friends, bro.
I made like one or two friends and that's it.
College is fun.
But do you think college is different for girls than it is for guys?
Yeah.
No, I dead don't.
I think it is. I think girls...
I think girls
focus more during college than boys. Like, I feel like boys, they be like on a sports team and like barely passing, and then girls might be more focused and organized trying to get A's and stuff like that.
It depends on the boy.
My
crush from from that school.
You baited?
Mm-hmm. No.
He's a bum.
Anyway, my actual crush that was in my organic chemistry class with me. He was helping me. So it just depends. Yeah. And he was a lifeguard. Like, how much more can we have in common?
Yeah, one my closest guy friend, he...
Relax.
Sad.
It's sad. He always did better than me. Like, I used him to motivate myself to do good. Like, and he was like basically my only guy friend, really.
But it also depends on who you hang out with, though.
That's true. That is so true. Because I've seen girls that are so, so smart that will fail because all their friends want to do is smoke and party. So it really depends on who you associate yourself
with. But you can have a nice mixture, though. Like, I have friends who I have friends who love smoking.
But is that all they do?
I mean, they don't only smoke. They, you know, they're like involved in the campus, but they also do their work. You, like, if you're in a friend group like that, you have to be the one that motivates other people.
You gotta be centered.
Yeah, like,
know what
if I know that they have homework, etc. to do, I'm not gonna sit there and be like, oh, okay, yeah, let's go all night, and you didn't look at one book yet.
True.
I'm the one that's like, let's go to the library, let's go here, da da da. So if that is your friend group, which is nothing wrong,
oh my god,
that
reminds me. I made my friends make a Google calendar and we synced our calendars up.
So
and I would be like, all right, so let's go to the library and study this.
College sometimes we accountability.
Go, but like we had the it was the
it's about, yeah. And it's okay to fall off track sometimes. Like, I feel like that's something that's important to state, but it's like it's all about the get back.
Nah, for real. Because sometimes I would be like, damn, I really don't care no more. But they had already graduated, so I'm like, I'm not about to take
it's
an
about
L.
To get back
I'm not about to be the dumb one in the group. Like, I was like, I had to graduate. Bro, especially when Corona hit, I was doing no work. But then I would be texting them like, yo, they not in college. I'm the only one here in college. Like, I can't be taking this L like this. So that would motivate me to make sure to get my work done. And this one class, I knew I was going to fail. Tell me why. I finessed, y'all.
As you
I
should.
Finessed.
As you should.
College is also about finesse. But yeah, thanks guys for watching. There will definitely be a part two coming soon. Hope you guys enjoyed.
Thank you. Bye. Bye.